Right, today I was hoping to take out a Kawasaki Z1000, but I was a bit late, I must admit, to get to the dealer, and therefore I ended up with the closest equivalent, which is a Z1000SX, I had to think that. Basically the same bike, but with more fairings, more suited for touring. So I've got this one just for killing some time, basically. And what they call officially lost at the moment, because I don't know the area too well, and well, I jumped on the bike, rode off, and had some long list of directions from the gentleman at the dealer. Didn't really understand any of it, and I just went, yeah, I understand that. And next thing you know, I'm somewhere where I have no clue where I am. Not to worry. So I'm doing this one just for the time being, just having a look at this particular bike for the time being, whilst the other one comes back, because it's already gone out on a test ride. This one so far, I'll be honest, because I've been riding through traffic, I haven't really had a chance to properly open it up. I've not really gone beyond about 6,000 RPM, plenty of torque there, around that mid-range. So, but I'm not going to lie, like I say, I've not really taken it to anywhere near its capacity, because A, I don't know the roads, and B, I've been stuck primarily in traffic. So as I say, a bit of time to go really. Apparently this one's got three different modes, if you can just see it there. You've got the full power, and you can select between full power and lower power. So I'm on full power at the moment. You've got the traction control, which is one, level one, which I'm on up there. Level two and level three, so it becomes more and more intrusive. On level three, so ideally for the wet. And as I say, I've got it on level one now, so it will kick in, but you know, it's a nice dry day today, so I'm going to kick in very often. And then you've got, of course, death mode, which I've been advised against, because, well, obviously I'm not on the track for one, and secondly, I've been riding a completely different style of bike, so to come onto this and put it straight into death mode would be quite ludicrous. So as I say, I've got it on one at the moment. Seems a fun bike, but as I say, I haven't really opened it up. It's a very nice looking bike. I'm not one for doing technical reviews, because as I say, I've literally got on this one without actually expecting to get on this one. But yeah, I mean, I'm thinking of having something different. This one does look very, very nice. If I did have this one, it would probably be over and above what I've already got. You know, I wouldn't get rid of mine to have this one, but it is a nice looking bike. I think they do it in a black and a orange, which would be my preference. So yeah, stock bike, so everything's standard. So I've got the double exhaust on either side. Nice little sound. Yeah, I think of what I ride at the moment. I better start heading back, because as I say, I've got to try and find my way back. I'm at least half an hour from the dealer, and I only had this bike for an hour, as I say, just for some time to kill. So it's a beautiful day today. Okay, nice riding back, and hopefully we'll have to hit 1,000 in a short while. Right then, folks, this is what I was talking about before. This is the bike that I originally wanted to take out and had to wait for, because there was a gentleman who got in before me because I was running a bit late. Funnily enough, I was running late because I had to wear the full leathers for a bike like this. Well, not had to, but, you know, makes sense to. I ride a Harley generally, and to be honest, that was one thing that was a bit, reminded. And I thought, that's exactly the reason why I enjoy riding a Harley more. Having said that, once I got kitted up and got on this bike is a lot of fun. I couldn't say this, but I've done a lot of wheelies so far. So, this bike is very, very terrific. I've just had the SX 1000, which is a similar bike to this, but this one feels so much lighter, so much more responsive. It's just brilliant. Around the corners, this feels really comfortable. As I say, it doesn't take a lot to get the front wheel up, intentionally or unintentionally. So I do like this one a lot more than the SX. The SX just felt heavy in comparison. So yeah, this one, as I say, I wasn't expecting in first gear pulling off the lights just for the wheel to come up so easily, and it did. So the first time it caught me a bit by surprise, but there on after, been enjoying it, loving it. Bike is beautiful. As I say, just doing a bit of a walk around. Not going to do too much of a technical review, apart from the fact that, you know, what I've enjoyed more in terms of riding the bike. This one is certainly a lot more fun. As I say, coming up towards the local area known as Bridgemoor, and some windy twisting. A lot more basic than the SX. The SX is obviously designed a bit more for, you know, longer journeys, as opposed to this one, which is in town commuting or just, you know, short blasts on country lanes, which is what I'm doing today. As I say, it depends what you like to ride, really. This one has been so fun so far. A lot more basic bike, not got all the rider aids that the SX had, but it's not got ABS, traction control, or anti-wheelie as they call it. I'm not entirely sure if the SX had anti-wheelie, to be honest. Certainly the S1000RR, you know, that kind of bike, or track bike, has all those type of features. This one definitely doesn't have any of that. The SX1000, I'm guessing, if you put it onto the level settings that I was showing you earlier on, 1 to 3, I'm guessing if you put it onto 3, it's not going to let you do many, you know, wheelies, or let you pull away too quick anyway, because as I say, that's primarily for wet riding. But as I say, I didn't really get a chance to push the SX. Nowhere near, obviously, the bike's limit, but my limit, even because, well, I don't know the roads too well, and I was stuck in traffic for the best part of it. And lastly, I was, not just stuck in traffic, I didn't really, I got a bit lost, if I'm honest. So, spent a bit longer than what I had the actual bike for. But this is a beautiful looking bike, also completely different to what I ride at the moment, but I just wanted to get the feel for something a bit more quirky than what I currently ride. This is actually last year's model, which basically means they haven't changed a lot apart from the colours. So the bike is essentially the same, but at the moment they do the other way around, I think it is, the colour. So the black is the predominant colour, and then there's little bits of orange. I think the 2015, the current model, looks a lot nicer in the predominantly black, and then secondary colour has been orange. So, as I say, this is a beautiful bike. Let's go on and ride it a bit more then. Right then, you're on board with the Z1000 Kawasaki, and we're just going to take some footage with my cheapo camera and see what that looks like when we eventually edit it.